Thank you for leaving your scythe down there. Hi there, young person. What's your name? Mason? Is that right? Make some noise for Mason, everybody. Now, Mason, before we do this, two quick questions. First, Mason, do you know what a personal injury lawyer is? Good. Second question, Mason. Now, these days, kids aren't really used to being hogtied anymore, and sometimes when I laugh at them, they start to cry, and it makes me look bad. So, Mason, when I laugh at you, are you going to start crying? Guess I'm going to have to roll those dice. All right, Mason, stand right there, right on the trap door. Good. Now, Mason, it might be a little bit late to ask this, but do you know what it means to be hogtied? You're going to find out. See if I can get the first part of this trick to work. Not everyone's applauding. I get it. You could have seen that anywhere. Like in the parking lot of a Buc-ee's. Hey, Mason, hands out of the rope, arms straight out like this. Hey, Mason, do not move your arms, and up. I know. That's the other arm straight out, Mason, straight out. I'm going to try to backhand that one, and up. Mason, was that scary? Kind of. Have his wits come out later. Face that way, Mason. Mason. Oh, hey, I see the guy in the back with a camera pointed at us. You know that guy? No, put the camera down, you creep. Hey, Mason, hands straight out like this. Straight out like this. Good. And, hop. Mason, turn and face me. One foot out like this. Just off the ground a little bit more. Good enough. Other foot up. Mason, now we've come to the final, most difficult part of hog tying a child. The part where everything can go sideways, because the child can literally go, womp. Doesn't look like he cares. So what we're gonna do, Mason, put your feet tied together. I'll say ready, jump. You're gonna jump in the air, all through a loop, and try to get both feet at the same time. Let's do a practice jump. Ready, jump. Okay, feet tied together, don't kick your heels back. Ready, jump. That might work. Let's see. Ready, and jump. Hey, I said this works half the time. Ready, jump. Ready, jump. Years of experience. Mason, now it's your time to shine. You get to be an escape artist just like Harry Houdini. Audience, have you heard of Harry Houdini?
Yes.
Mason, have you heard of Harry Houdini? Get a book. Mason, we're going to see if you can escape from the rope on the count of seven. Do you think you can do it? Audience, do you think you can do it?
Yes.
That is too much confidence. There. And Mason, based on what happened in the last show, I must specify escape from the rope, not from the show. Some kids go to a Montessori school. When I start counting, you start escaping. Betty, Ann, no cheating. Get back in it, get back in it. A little more. You get out of it. All right, he's too fast. No, let me fix it. All right, Mason, no, put your little hands out, put your little mitts out. Mason, you get the constrictor knot. I keep tightening it until the kid says, ow. All right, a little masochist, okay. When I start counting, you start escaping. You just want them all back. Ready, and 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go! Mason, here is your prize. You win this Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle sticker. I give those out because I was born in the 1900s. So make some noise if you've seen this show before. Two of you. Make some noise if you've never seen this show. More of you.
Make some noise if you're ready to see me do something.
Before we get to the whip cracking, I'd like to play my harmonica. All right, kids, here comes the first whip crack of the show. It's going to be kind of loud. You may want to plug your ears. Whip! I know. Let's see if I can get a few more people up here to watch this show. Our whip show, right this way. Free haircuts, free babysitting,
and free vasectomies.
I don't know, you need one, you need one? You brought three kids, you want one? Now, Zen out in Ohio, whip crash, raise your hand, he's in Ohio, whip crash. Yes, you need Lego.
It breaks the sonic.
It breaks the sonic, right? That's correct, a round of applause. That's right, I need a cool whip crack. It's a sonic boom, the end of the whip. Going faster than the speed of sound. Whip even goes fast enough that it can break bone, but not everyone believes that. So hands together if you think a whip could break bone. Not everyone applauded. Baby, hold your hand up. This is called Darwinism. Because I'm kidding, keep your hand out. I'm not gonna whip another kid. hi there, who belongs to that water bottle right there? Which one of you? Yours, what's your name?
Danielle.
Danielle, hold it up. Like in front of your face. Danielle, I will unscrew the cap from that water bottle.
No!
Danielle, I'm gonna borrow your bottle cap for a trick later in the show. You might even get it back. I don't know. We'll see. So Danielle, in my 30-year whip career, I've been on the Travel Channel, the Discovery Channel, the History Channel, the Science Channel, the Steve Harvey Show, Conan O'Brien, the Gong Show, America's Got Talent, and just this year I was on HBO. I was in that Renfair documentary about this place for 1 second, and that counts.
Let's see if I can get this next trick to work.
We're going to go around the outside, behind the back, up into the alley, the armpit, behind the back, again, and around the neck, and under the leg. All that usually gets a larger response.
Woo!
Yeah. Hello. I am also surprised. And then after watching, Magic Mike.
Woo!
Now, this next trick I learned on my last trip to Australia. I'm the only one outside of Australia who can do it.
Yeah!
Do not fact check that. It's called upside down and backwards. How do you like the view?
Woo! Woo! Woo!
Nobody ever takes this picture.
I'm not doing this pose because it looks cool. I'm doing it because it helps my plantar fasciitis. Thank you, sir, for reminding me where my catchphrase goes. Y'all ready to see something dangerous?
Yeah!
Very well, then I'll need a manly man to help me out. A He-Man! Or someone who remembers the cartoon He-Man. But let's see if we can find any manly men. You were sitting in the front. You obviously wanted to be picked. Hi there, what's your name?
Bruce.
Bruce, make some noise for Bruce, everybody.
Woo!
Bruce, are you having a good day so far? That's about to change.
Wasn't sure you got picked.
First thing, Bruce, take that.
Woo! Woo!
Whoa.
Bruce is not vanilla. Wait, she's got like two phones up, Bruce. Here, hold up. Take this picture. Hold on a little whip handle. Take this picture. Hashtag fire whip show. So, Bruce, a couple summers ago, I was on America's Got Talent. Did anybody see it?
Yeah.
Few of you? That's fine. If you missed it, right now, I'll recreate what I did on the show with the help of Bruce. It's something I call the three challenges of the bullwhip. And, Bruce, if you pass them, you will win this Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle sticker. And when we are done, you will hold your sticker aloft and say, that was not worth it. First, Bruce, I'm going to say the name of each test. I'd like you to repeat each name in a loud, dramatic fashion with hand gestures and everything. Are you ready?
Ready.
The three challenges are bravery.
Bravery.
Dramatic pause. Dexterity.
Dexterity.
And idiocy.
Idiocy.
Not bad. First, Bruce, test the bravery. I'll take these two whips. I'll crack them right around you. I'll do my best to not hit you. Now, Bruce, have you ever had a whip cracked around you before?
No.
Have you ever had a crack whipped around you before?
Can't remember.
Some dudes back up. All right, face that way, Bruce. Hands on your side. As they say on Dora the Explorer, no tame huevas. One lady is bilingual. Oh, that means don't move.
Woo!
And Bruce's shorts are still the same color. He is really brave. Now, Bruce, for the test of dexterity. So a couple of years ago, I bought a lot of toilet paper for no reason. been trying to figure out what to do with all of it, so I created a toilet paper lasso. All you're going to do, Bruce, is swing this over your head in a very large, graceful circle. Not too much for this. Nice, big, easy circle overhead. All right, level it out. Overhead, level it out. Good. That is easily the best that has gone so far today. Bruce, did it have dexterity? And finally, Bruce, do me a big favor. Take this piece and put it in your back pocket.
Right.
You do not want it in the front. See, which way is the wind blowing? Okay, face the dude in the scooter over there. I stop, feet apart, squat down. Squat a little bit, good. I know.
He likes
right,
it.
Don't watch, Bruce, don't watch. Oh, Bruce, if you feel anything, that's your imagination. Yeah, so I've done this a while now, Bruce. I have learned if a guy goes home and says, I went to the Renaissance and some dude whipped me in the face, that's bad. However, if he goes home and says, I went to the Renaissance and some dude whipped me in the butt, that's good. Let's get that last piece. I need a different angle on it. Could you put your butt like up more in the air, a little bit more in the air? A lot of cake back there, Bruce. A lot of cake. The three challenges of the bowl. And Bruce, here is your prize, your Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle sticker. Thank you very much, Bruce. Enjoy the rest of the day. Round of applause for Bruce, everybody. It's finally time to light something on fire! Before we get the fire rip out, I'd like to thank all of you so much for coming to my show this morning. At the end of the show, I'm going to be there in the back with a basket on for tips and donations. This is where I make my living. So if you enjoyed the show, consider coming up, maybe throwing in a couple bucks or a five, whatever the show's worth to you. And if you donate $10 or more, you can get one of my crack addict pins. Now, let me get applaud, crack addict. Thanks, sir. Let me get the fire started by getting the chant. This is the $5 trick. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 9, 10, 15, 16, 17, 20.
Woo!
All right, keep your eyes on the bottle cap.
Woo! Woo!
And here you go, Danielle. Here's your bottle cap. Remember, reduce, reuse, and recycle. It was only on the head of a sweaty, middle-aged, bald man. So I think we've got time for one more stunt. Y'all want to see one more?
Yeah!
Well, it's time to current Guinness World Record holder for heaviest whip crack. Y'all want to see my heaviest whip?
Yeah!
Very well, give me a second. Break out the record. I'm already tired. I built a grapple whip that weighed over 22 pounds. Then we took a 5-foot steel axle, an 8-foot logging chain, welded them together, that 8-foot whip on the end of that, making a whip that weighs 27 pounds. Now, isn't that a long show? I'm kind of tired. You don't need to see me crack this, do ya?
Yeah!
Okay. Hey, Baden, have you ever heard of a rotator cuff?
No.
Yeah, here we go. Trying to crack the 27-pound whip. Let's see. Oop, it's tighter than that. You want to see that again?
Yeah. Come to the next show.
Come to the next show. Now I'll do one more quick one. Another record I set a few years ago. Let's roll quick cracks in a minute. With two whips, 646. Here's how fast I go to set that record.
Adam! Woo!
Thank you very much, well done, Pat. Thank you. Thank you. Now, for real, everybody. Thank you. Thank you. I'll be right in the back. What do you want, kid? Do you want a pin for $10?
Yeah!
All right. There you go. Right, hold on to it. Go sit down. Go sit down. Go sit down. Let me take your hand.
There you go.
All right, so I'm going to do some parenting. There we go. I'll be in the back. Thank you very much. Mind's on track. Enjoy the rest of your day. Thank you.